Hello, and welcome to this tutorial on Microsoft PowerPoint, the office product that allows you to realize dynamic presentations and slideshows. In just 13 minutes, we're going to see all the features you need to know to make a successful presentation showing content, data analysis, and representations in a Windows machine. When opening PowerPoint, the homepage appears with quick options to start from a new project or open an existing one you have. To start right away, just pick any of the ready templates and open the main interface. This interface is very simple. On top, you have the ribbon bar with tabs collecting tools and features we are going to see. On the left, the slides list, and on the center, the big preview. You can also change the interface colors by going to File, Options, General, and selecting the right ones from Office Theme. First of all, let's understand what is a PowerPoint project. This is indeed a presentation made by several pages or slides, each made by several objects put together. These can be pieces of text, shapes, tables, charts, or media files. Make sure to download our simple presentation from the video description. When you start from a new presentation, this shows a couple of slides with sample content inside. You can go to New Slide on top to add new slides following the template chosen, each with different kinds of objects inside. You can also select any slide from the left and go to Layout to change its layout, or to the Design tab to completely change its appearance and size. All these slides are listed on the left from top to bottom. You can drag any up or down to change its position, and right-click on it to cut, copy, paste, or delete it. Now let's understand how to edit the slide's content. Click within text titles to type inside. These are called text boxes, showing text content within a dashed box that you can drag to move. You can also use its nodes to rotate and resize, adjusting the text distribution and size inside. From the Home tab, you can adjust text font, size, style, and letter spacing. Make sure to select any text in case you do not see any modification. You can also set background color, font color, distribution within the box, and line spacing. You may go to View, Ruler, to customize the text distribution as you like. To add links on any selected text, go to Insert, Link. This way you add direct links to any document or even hyperlinks from the web. Whereas use Equation and Symbol to add math equations and symbols. Check these out. You can also make bulleted and numbered lists. On Home, Paragraph, select the list to add, and click on the down arrow to set the symbol to use. As you make a new line, a following symbol or number is added automatically. If you do not see it, just make a new text box with Insert, Shapes, Text Box. Use the Tab key to enter sublines, and Shift and Tab to come back to the previous line. You can also use the ruler to adjust spacings in detail. From Insert, Shapes, you can also add shapes and lines. Just pick any and click and drag to drop it. You can always drag it to move it and use its nodes to rotate, scale, or reshape. You can also include text inside by right-clicking on it and going to Edit Text. When selecting text or shapes, the Shape Format tab appears above, with all the properties you can adjust for the object. Apply any ready template with shape styles, and customize the object fill color, contour color, and style with outline, and add special visual effects with shape effects. Whereas use Word Art Styles to set the font color, contour, and effects. With Insert, Table, you can make a table with the proper number of rows and columns. You can type within any cell and extend its borders by dragging these. To move the entire table, drag from its borders and use its nodes to resize it. From the Home tab, you can adjust text as seen for the text boxes by either selecting text or even entire cells. On Table Design, set the table appearance by picking any ready style or applying the right background color or border on the selected cells. On the right, use Draw Table to draw the contours one by one with proper line style, thickness, and color above. With Layout, you adjust the general table layout, removing or adding columns and rows, or even merging or splitting selected cells. Make sure to set the text alignment properly. Now let's see how to implement charts, such as graphic representations of databases. Make sure to have Microsoft Excel installed to get the most from these charts on PowerPoint. Go to Insert, Chart, and select the kind of chart from the templates of Microsoft Excel. The new chart takes some default data from an integrated Excel sheet that you can edit to update the chart representation. You can move, resize, and also add or remove chart elements from its plus button. With chart design above, set the chart appearance and change the chart type. Whereas click on Select Data to select the data series to plot, and Edit Data to open the Excel sheet again. With Format, adjust the shape and the text properties as seen for other objects. Make sure to watch our dedicated video to learn more about the Excel charts. From the Insert tab, you can also import media files such as pictures, video, and audio files. Complete with an integrated player. You can move, resize these, and open the Format panel above to adjust the visual appearance, correct brightness, colors, transparency, and apply ready styles, colored borders, and great visual effects. Whereas enable crop on the right to crop the visual media as you need. On pictures and video, you can open the playback tab to add bookmarks, trim the file, add fade transitions, and adjust the volume level. All these elements composing your slide can be managed in the same way. You can right-click on these to cut, copy, and paste, using Control or Command and Z to undo. You can also go to Format to open the Format panel on the right, collecting the complete set of properties for the current object. Check these out. If objects overlap, you can go to Home, Arrange to set the order of visibility, taking the selected object as reference. Select Bring Forward, Backward to move it up or down once, and Bring to Front and Send to Back to overcome all the other objects. To present your slides in full screen mode, open the SlideShow tab. At this point, move through the presentation with the arrow keys, or go on with a click. In the bottom left corner, you get additional buttons to interact with your attendees. You can transform your cursor into a well-visible laser pen, or into a pen or highlighter to draw freehand and underline specific parts. To end the presentation, use the Escape key. When working with projectors, it is very useful to enable multiple screens by clicking Windows and P on Windows OS. In this case, you can show your presentation on the projector and read notes or taking up time in your main screen using the presenter view. You can also record the presentation with the Recording tab. extracting the result with Export to Video. By default, the presentation is completely static, but you can add dynamic effects with transitions and animations. Inside the Transitions tab, you find loads of effects that you can apply between two consecutive slides. Click on any to apply it on the current slide and customize it with effect options. You can also add sound, set duration, and much more on the right. Click on Preview to check it again, and select None to remove any transition applied. Under the Animations tab, you find several motion effects for each single element of your slide. Just select any object and pick the right animation, adjusting properties with Effect options. On Add Animation, you find the complete effects list, divided into four groups: the green entrance animations to make the object appear, the yellow emphasis to animate the object in place, the red exit effects to make the object disappear, and the motion paths to move the object from the green arrow to the red one. You can also open the animation pane to get a complete list of all the animations applied within the current slide, including the playback of videos and audio files. When you click on Play All, PowerPoint plays all these in order, respecting placement, delays, and duration for each animation block. For example, if you move any block on the right, you add a proper pause before playing it. Whereas if you extend the block, you make the animation longer and slower, according to the timeline at the bottom. You can also drag any animation up or down to change the order, and edit the animation effect by selecting it and picking another one. To save your presentation, go to File, Save As, choose .pptx or .pptm to save it as a PowerPoint project to reopen and edit it anytime. Whereas switch to a .pdf format to export the presentation as a document, without any transition or animation applied. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Do not forget to visit our website and subscribe to our channel to discover more free and outstanding tutorials.